Okay, 12:15 p.m. It's October 13th, 2014. And as if the wind wasn't bad the last 4 years, 5 years, I've just constantly been every day. There's some heavy storms coming off across the Mississippi River. I'm gonna try to shield the microphone so you can hear me with my hand, because the wind's blowing so bad out here. I thought I'd come out here just to show you. See, we're out in the middle of open like this. And me and my crazy thoughts, which right now, but we'll see if I'm so crazy in the next maybe 6 months or a year. But they've been suggesting about Ebola becoming airborne, you know, suggesting it. Although there are unconfirmed reports that yes, in fact, it is airborne. And again, with this complete insane mafioso that's running everything, and most people laugh that off still because, you know, stupid is as stupid does, you know, and I'm not calling anybody stupid, you can prove that to yourselves. They will do anything they can to depopulate as much as they can. So why would not a host of diseases, maybe Ebola per se, when they won't screen these people when they come into this country, they let the illegals from the southern border come in here, then they fight to keep them secret and hide them all over the damn country, and there have been reports of them actually having some diseases, including Ebola. So maybe when you can stop laughing, get your head out of your ass, clean the shit off of your eyes and out of your mouth, you'll understand. Perhaps what they're doing is setting the stage for a massive pandemic. I mean, I've been saying something about the wind blowing for the last 6 years, every single day. I mean, some days it's been very mild, but it has been present. But I would say 70% of the time it was more than it would normally be in a given day. I've got my garden fairly just about tilled up. I got some purple hull peas right here. And black eyed peas still growing. I want to get about maybe 8 more pods out there, and then I'll tear them up this next weekend. But see, I've got bean plants from where seeds are falling into the ground and whatnot growing already on this. But that's all got to be tilled back up and put plastic over all this. Okra too. I've got maybe about 12 okra pods that are coming out right now, but they're all small. They'll be out by the weekend, if not sooner. And then those are all going to come down. And the peppers too. I got about 8 pepper plants over there. Bell peppers and some habanero peppers. Gonna pick those, get seeds off of at least half, and then pickle the others, I guess. But the garden next year should be so much more. At least 190 plants we can get in out here. But we don't want to have that many. We'll probably get it down to like 150. So, and with the plastic, 99% of everything will grow. Won't be all the disease. We got peppers up around the house there. Those are all habanero peppers. There's 5 plants up there. 4 of them are habanero peppers. And one of them is cayenne. I already tore up 3 plants from up there and a tomato plant. Because of this disease, because the soil was so poor. I've got lime and I've got 15-15 fertilizer to go out here in this garden. After the plastic gets on there, that'll be the end of it. And then we'll just grow the plants from plants in pots. And after about 12 weeks, when they get to about 12 inches high or so, they'll all be planted out here. We'll, like I said, at least 150 plants out here. It'll be completely different looking. And like I say, 99% of everything will grow. And it should grow really good. But just for something for people to talk about, think about the wind. The wind out here, it's stronger than usual. It's abnormal. Man, God is doing everything it can to cause enough illness to kill off everybody. Knockout roses here on my 4 o'clocks I planted. They came out really nice. They're still holding out here. The other ones I planted on the other side are gone. They look like they're ready for the winter. My other chimes got totally whipped. Yeah, see, look at the stems right here. They're not back out on the 4 o'clock right here. There. 4 o'clock here just died off. Same thing in the next couple weeks. Knockout roses will get cut back in spring if my wife doesn't cut them out this fall. And the impatience, now's when they're all coming out. Look at them on both sides of the steps. Wreaking havoc out here. So, like I said, people can call me paranoid all they want, they can laugh all they want, but I'll tell you what, and I'm dead serious on this. When the shit does hit the fan, I better not see a group of people coming down the road down there, across this field. I better not see them coming down the road down there, across that field. Across that field out back there. You can take this for however you want. You will not be welcomed here. You've been told enough over the last 6 years, 7 years. I keep talking about people because, yeah, you keep saying it, okay? Well, you know what? The time is at hand. And I'm going to tell you, if something doesn't happen between now and let's just say March, which is a long way off, which I know for a fact, at least two catastrophic things are going to happen between now and then. But if it didn't happen by March, then you know what? I won't ever make another video about any of this. And I'll just do what I need to do to protect myself and my family, how I see fit. Even though it still happens, I'm not going to give you any more information. I'm not going to try to help you. I'll just do what I feel I need to do for my family. And you just shit on your own. All right? Now you know. I try to help you, I point out things to people, and I don't see or hear anybody making a goddamn thing about it. So you know what? Have at it. Good luck. Goodbye.